Hello everyone, welcome to this session of Classics Mathematics, and I am your Anu for MathSchool.1 again. Now, last class we have been seeing the chapter 3, playing with numbers, and we have seen how to find the highest common factor, that is HCF, by various methods. Now let me summarize all those methods. Okay, so finding HCF, so one of the method is by prime factorization. We find the prime factors, list them out, and we find the highest common prime factors among the numbers. Then we have seen the long division method. Then after this, I told you about the Euclid's algorithm. Watching out for the remainder 0, and the divisor responsible for getting a remainder 0 will be the HCF in that. And the last one was the division algorithm. The division algorithm says dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So these were the methods which we used to find HCF. Okay, so you can refer to my part 2, where I have described all those methods, and we'll be seeing these methods one by one when we move on to the problems. Okay, when we solve problems in this chapter, I'll be explaining you again with numerical examples all these methods. And now, after finishing HCF, let us move on to LCM. Now, as I told you, HCF is the highest common factor. As the name implies, where does the HCF is applied, or where does the HCF has its application, is when a large number, I mean one or two numbers, just take for example some two numbers are given, when two bigger numbers are given, when you are asked to find the HCF, the highest common factor, what do we do is we make the bigger numbers into equal fractions, and we see that each fraction is maximum. Okay, we get the maximum possible fraction out of it. So that is the meaning of HCF, the highest common factor, that is fraction, that is making a part, making parts of the bigger number, and seeing to that we get the maximum amount of that fraction. When we fraction a bigger number, we can get either a smaller one or a bigger one. Like when we write factors for 8, see, when we write factors for 8, we can write 4 into 2 or 1 into 8, isn't it? If 1 is repeated 8 times, also we get 8, or if 4 is repeated 2 times, we also get 8. But when we take 4 in 2 rows, isn't it? When we take 4 in 2 rows, or more better than that, if I take 8 in just one row, I get a maximum, that is a larger part. But this 8 is not a part, it is a whole. So if I need to fraction this 8, I take 4 into consideration. So this will be my highest factor. Do you understand? So I'll make the arrangement such that each row has 4 objects in it. So that will be the maximum maximum number in that fraction. Do you understand? So that is, this concept is applied in HCF for highest common factors. And wherever we need fractions of bigger numbers and a maximum number in that particular fraction, HCF is used. So do always remember, when a bigger number is made into fractions or a smaller number is asked and equal parts are asked, you should just remind yourself that we need to find HCF. Now the next thing is LCM, that is the lowest common multiple. Lowest common multiple. What does it mean? Lowest common multiple. See, if I write 3, okay, and I'm writing 8, let me find out what will be the lowest, what will be the common multiple, what are the common multiples among these two numbers. First is 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30, 33, 36, and 39, 42, and so on, isn't it? 45, 48, and so on. So we get the multiples of 3. Now for 8, it is 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, 48, 8 sevens are, sorry, 48, 56, 64 and so on. So these are the multiples for 3 and 8 I have listed down. Now just see what are the common multiples among these two numbers. See, first is 24. I have 24 here. And the next common number is, sorry, 48. Isn't it? So likewise, you will be having common multiples in both the numbers. But what we are interested is the lowest common multiple or the least common multiple, that is 24. Because 24 occurs first and it is common in both the numbers, both the numbers multiples list. So we take 24 as the least common multiple. You understand? So where is this LCM? The concept of LCM is applied is the number, see, the 24 is repeated again. We see that if 3 and 8 are taken, if 3 and 8 are taken, the multiples are written and we see which is a point where the numbers exactly coincide or they meet each other. The multiples of 3 and 8 meet each other. That is, we keep on multiplying at a certain number of, at a certain point of time, we get the same number or we get the same result in both the numbers, isn't it? So this concept of LCM is applied where an incident happens and it is going on. The incident is going on simultaneously and at some point of time it becomes equal. The incident where some two or three members are doing this same thing but they are doing it differently, but at some point of time they do the same thing, that is their positions are same at particular point. So we need to find that point, that is the first occurrence of that point, and that will be the least common multiples concept. So there we apply LCM to find the first meeting point of such incidents. So that is the concept behind LCM, and wherever we need to find some multiples or a larger value where all the incidents coincide, then there we apply the concept of LCM. Okay, so when we do word problems, when we do some application problems in LCM, you will get to know the real application of LCM. Now we'll learn how to find out LCM numerically. Okay, so how to find LCM? Now we are given with two numbers, say 21 and 49. So there are two numbers and we need to find the LCM of 21 and 49. As usual, as we did for HCF, let us prime factorize the two numbers. So 21 and 49, I am prime factorizing both the numbers. So let it be 3 and 7. See, 3 sevens are 21. I need to prime factorize. Keep that in mind. We need to put only prime factors, not any other composite numbers. So 7 sevens are 49. Okay, so now list. This is 3 into 7 and 49 is 7 into 7. For my convenience, what I write is, I write the occurrence of the numbers shortly. That is, I write, see, 3 power 1 into 7 power 1. What does it mean? 3 occurs one time and 7 occurs one time. The number upon this is called the power or the exponent. The power or the exponent tells us how many times the number gets repeated. Say for example, when I write 7 into 7, I write 7 square. This is called 7 square, where 2 is the power of 7. 7 to the power of 2, we say 7 to the power of 2, or we say 7 square. If I say 7 square, it means I multiply 7 2 times. Note that it is not equal to 2 into 7. This is wrong. 2 into 7 is 14, but 7 into 7 is 49. So 7 square means you should multiply 7 2 times. So for my convenience, I write 7 square. 7 occurs 2 times and here 3 occurs 1 time and 7 occurs 1 time. So whenever we need to find LCM, see, now I am finding LCM for 21 and 49. So whenever we find LCM, see the number of maximum occurrence. Okay, collect the numbers of maximum occurrence. See, first I see 3 here, 3 to the power 1. So just 3 to the power 1 is there. Here 3 is not there in the number. So take that number. So it is 3 to the power 1. There in HCF, we found which are all the numbers that are common to the numbers which are common to all the numbers. We group them together, we pair them together and take one number from it, isn't it? Here, we need to take the numbers according to their occurrence. So 3, one time I have taken 3. And see here, 7 it occurs one time and here it occurs 2 times. So maximum occurrence is 2, isn't it? So I take 7 square. Do you understand? So what happened to this 2? You may have a question. Never mind, you leave it. You just concentrate on the maximum occurrence. That is, you just see the power. Where it is larger, you take that power. Okay, so 7 square. So 3 into 49. So what is it? 147. So 147 is the LCM of 21 and 49. Do you understand? So this is one sum. I'll just do another sum for you to understand still more clearly. Okay, so the next one is 36 and 14. You need to find the LCM of 36 and 14. So now let us do 36 and 14. I'm prime factorizing 36 to 18. 2 9s are 18. 3 3s are 9. So until you get 1, you prime factorize. And for 14, it is 2 and 7. Now just list them. 36 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. And for 14, is it is just 2 into 7. So for my convenience, I write 2 square into 3 square. And this is 2 power 1 into 7 power 1. Now take the numbers of maximum occurrence in both the numbers. See, here it is 2 squared and here it is 2 to the power 1. So 2 square is greater, so I write 2 square. And next is 3 square here, but 3 is not there, so I take 3 square. Even if it is not there, you just take whatever 3 is there, you take those 3. Then 7 power 1 is here, but here 7 is not there, so take 7 power 1. You need to take all the numbers, but provided you should take the numbers which has maximum occurrence. Okay, that numbers of maximum occurrence. So 2 squared is 4, 3 squared is 9. I said 2 squared is 2 into 2. 3 squared is 3 into 3, not 2 into 3. Okay, into 7. So 36 into 7 is 252. So the LCM of 36 and 14 is 252. Now do you understand how do we find the LCM? Okay, so this is how we find LCM. Now there is another method called the long division method. As we did for HCF, we can do for LCM too, the long division method. In HCF, see, in HCF we just put the factors which are common to both the numbers. If two numbers are given, for both the numbers, you need to take a common factor and you need to divide. But in LCM, it is not the condition. See, let's see the same example at 36 and 14. So first is, I write 2 here, 18 and 7. See, I have got 18 and 7. If at all, I need to find HCF of 36 and 14, I stop with this. Because I can't proceed after this because there is no common factor for 18 and 7. So I'll stop with this and I'll take this 2 as HCF. But in LCM, you can continue. See, I can continue by taking one number. So for 2, for 18, I write 3. I put 6 here. But 7, for 7, 3 is not a factor, isn't it? So bring that 7 as it is. Now for this 6, I write 3 again. So 3 2s are 6. Again, 7 is there. It is not a 3 is not a factor of 7. So bring that 7. Bring it down. Now put 2 here. 2 1s are 2, isn't it? So 7 is again. So 2 is not a factor of 7. So bring that 7 again. And put this 7 here. 1, 1. Now do you understand? Until you get 1, 1, you can divide. So you need not see whether these two numbers have common factor for LCF. For HCF, you need to see whether this is a factor of both the numbers. But for LCM, you can divide it separately. So now just list out the numbers. That is the LCM. You get the LCM directly by multiplying all the numbers in the left hand side. So 2 3s are 6, 6 3s are 18, 18 2s are 36, and 36 into 7 is again 252. So we got the same answer, isn't it? It is 252. Now do you understand how do we find LCM by long division method? Actually this is easier. Long division method is easy, and even that prime factorization is also easier. Just we need to remember, we need to pick the numbers of maximum occurrence. But we tend to make mistakes in that in that method by prime factorizing it. But we need to understand that method also. And this is the long division method, and this is very easy for you to understand. You keep on dividing with each, for each number separately you can divide and stop when it becomes 1. Okay, so then you need to multiply all the numbers in the left side. So that is about LCM. So in this class we have recollected some points of HCF, and we have seen what does LCM means, and what are the methods by which LCM can be found. Now with this I end the class, and in the next class we'll see what is the relationship between HCF and LCM. We'll see some problems related to it and some aspects of HCF and LCM too. So we'll meet in the next class. Until then, it's bye from Anu for MathSchool.1.